Hello, God bless you. I'm reading from the book of Numbers, chapter number 23, verse number 10. Who can count the dust of Jacob and the number of the fourth part of Israel? Let me die the death of the righteous, and let my last end be like his. Hallelujah. Since yesterday, we started talking about the dominion over untimely death. And one of the major things I said yesterday is that God has a date he expected you to live on earth if Jesus tarry. Understanding these is not like understanding every other thing. There are things you can waive. There are curses that are not mandatory in Christianity. One of the most important part of Christianity is in longevity. Jesus said the only purpose why he came is that you may live and have life and have it abundantly. In John chapter 10, verse number 10. That was where he defined the purpose of Satan and his own purpose. Satan came so that you can die young. I came so that you can have abundant life. Now, this scripture here spoke about there are all kinds of death. And here defined the fact that there's a death of the righteous. There's a death that looks unrighteous. When you don't fulfill your days, an unrighteous death. That doesn't mean you won't go to heaven. I'd like you to quickly get that. But it means that you would have caught up the privileges and all your purpose and what God would have wanted you to achieve here on earth. Too bad or too good, untimely death is not what somebody can believe God for. Otherwise, many people will believe God for longevity for their loved ones. No, it's a personal thing. It's as personal as when you want to go to the toilet. Nobody can do it for you. One major thing that you have to do for yourself, the children are on their own, the fathers are on their own, is the issue of dominion over untimely death. It must be a concept that you believe so passionately that even in your dream, you will be having some encounter and your mouth will be saying, no, I cannot die young. All the testimonies of people you hear about them dying young and suddenly they wake up is because of the investment into their spiritual dominion system over untimely death. So they will say the guy was already in the mortuary and something happened and the guy got up. Why? He's spiritually endowed with the grace of dominion over untimely death. One of the biggest ways to have dominion, like I started saying since the beginning of the month, is to speak dominating word, is to dominate the situation with your words. God saw darkness and he wanted to have dominion. He said, let there be light. So every time you hear about untimely death, you shouldn't say, hey, sorry. You shouldn't say, oh, and I love the guy. You should open your mouth and say, no, I will not die young. In the face of every untimely death news, either you saw it on social media or somebody close to you, is the very moment you should open your mouth and keep saying you have dominion over untimely death. So, there is a death for the righteous, there's a death for righteous. So, when you give your life to Jesus Christ, you activate the covenant of longevity. And when that happens, you should guard it jealously. He said, guard your heart jealously, guard your heart with all diligence, because out of it proceed the issues of life. So, it must never cross your mind that what if I die now? What if I do not live to see my children grow old? Every time such thought passes through your heart, and you don't take dominion over it, you are investing into untimely death. And nobody could be able to do anything about it. It's so bad. There are a lot of people who have gone through this road and we couldn't do anything about it. Because it's not what you can do for someone. It's not what anybody can do for you. That's why this broadcast is so important. You need to pay attention and listen to it over and over. That God has given you dominion over untimely death. And that if you don't take it, is going to take you. So I allow you to write it again today in capital letter. I refuse to die young. I have dominion over untimely death in Jesus' name. Amen.